everyone. We're here with Ken, who's showing us how to upcycle our old dresser drawers into stunning, one-of-a-kind shelving. Ken, you've done it again.
Why, thank you.
We haven't started yet, but you will be doing it again.
This is an interesting one because I get a lot of requests from clients and people who have big walls and want to know how to fill them up.
Yes.
You know, how to fill them up without spending a fortune or buying huge amounts of artwork or getting custom-made shelves to fill a space. So this is a really kind of chic, easy way to fill up that space without spending a lot of money.
Interestingly, just a couple days ago, I went to Ken and I said, I need some help with my den. I've got an open wall. And little did you know, I'm planning
yeah, he put it into my mind.
All right, so we got to come up, obviously, with some cool old shelves.
Okay, the interesting thing with the shelves, the drawers. So you can use, like, the old dresser that's in the garage, the one that's up in the attic. Use those. But if you need to go out, go to secondhand stores, Salvation Armies, all those. And if you don't, like, how are you going to get that big dresser home? Usually they will let you just buy the drawers. It's like, I would like to buy this for $35, but I'm just going to take the drawers and leave the rest there. So you can fit them in your trunk. You don't have to worry about transporting the big piece. And they will be happy to do it, and they'll get rid of the carcass for you. So
These are the tips that we love to get from you guys. He knows because he's done it.
Because I've done it.
All right, so we'll get our drawers, whether we do it like that or we have them at our house already. What else do we need?
Are you going to use a little spray glue? And then I have a couple of rolls of Hallmark gift wrap. And really, that's going to be at a French cleat, which we'll get to.
We'll get to a little bit later. Okay,
exactly.
Let's get started. Here's the thing. You've got two different techniques, two different styles of using this drawer.
Right.
Let's start with the shadow box style.
Shadow box one is the one that's flat, that sort of frames things all around.
Yeah.
And that one, let me show you. When you get your drawer here, first you want to start by prepping it.
Okay.
So your drawers are probably going to have, on this side, you can see here, they're probably going to have runners on the edge where they come in, and depending on the type. So you just want to go ahead and take those off with a screwdriver, super easy. And then you're also going to notice, depending on what type, you've got that little lip there. Can you see that little lip right there where it hangs out?
Of course.
Some will be flush and some will have a lip. If you have a lip, mark it with a pencil and just run a jigsaw down there to take off that lip.
Because this is going to be lying flat against
your
wall.
You don't want it to like float out.
Yeah, that would ruin the whole look.
Exactly. So that's easy enough.
Okay.
And then, you know, because all of mine were from the same dresser, I then painted them different colors to sort of give that look. Now you can see how nice and flush that is.
Yes.
So you're basically all ready. Now, if you want to pull out that one there, you've already got it there.
I've already got it going because I know we were going with this. And I see that you've already got the French cleat added to the back. And we'll get to that in a little bit.
And now I've went ahead and cut different paper. I picked a color palette for the whole thing. I picked our sort of blues and grays and greens, and then I found Hallmark wallpaper that is around that same color scheme.
Look at this palette here.
Cut it to size, and then all we're going to do
a little spray adhesive here.
Yeah, don't overthink this. A little bit of spray glue and pop your gift wrap.
Was that a don't overthink this, Cameron, or is that to everybody at home too?
Everybody at home. We'll go with that. That's my answer, and I'm sticking to
it.
But no, sometimes you're like, how do I do this? Do I get wallpaper for the back? Do I need wallpaper paste? Should I staple it? Should I upholster it? Some spray glue and some gift wrap.
Boom.
And
there we go.
You are done.
Okay, now we're going to leave these here for a second before we start hanging everything, because we're going to jump to the other technique that you use.
Right.
Which is actually the style where it looks like the drawer is coming out of the wall shelf.
Exactly. Okay. So I started off with the drawer like this. This is from a little cupboard that had a bunch of them. But you notice that it's pretty long here. And you as an engineer.
The first question I had for you, is there a maximum depth that you have to cut it off at? Because otherwise it's going to be too much torque.
I think you're going to have to put brackets underneath and that's not going to look good.
Right.
I found that 6 inches is good. You could probably go up to 8. But anything more than that, you're going to have to reinforce it.
Okay.
So 6 to 6 and 8. And I started this earlier. You're going to get your actual box and just measure with a little ruler. I just did 6 inches all around. And make it easy. If you get a speed square, boom, they'll all line up. You don't have to measure but once. Get your wood jigsaw, and then when you get to the edge, just curve it around. One cut around the whole thing. Now, you can either save that back that was already on there, or you can cut a new one out of plywood, a little bit of wood glue, line up your new back, use a nail gun or wood screws, whatever you have at home, and boom, you have your brand new little drawer.
I mean, it's a lot of, in a sense, a lot of bang for the buck. It's actually pretty doable.
Very doable.
Yeah.
Very, very, very nicely.
I love when you guys find DIYs that we can all do. For sure. Okay. Now you've obviously painted this guy.
I painted it. I picked some fun colors. And here with these, you really have fun with the hardware. Go to a secondhand store, go to a junk store, find interesting, weird hardware, put it on, because that's what really the quirkiness that really makes the magic. In these particular
put a little personality in that too.
Exactly.
Some of your own personality in there as well. Okay, so now comes the time, we've alluded to this already, that we're going to use some French cleats to get these guys on the wall.
Good old French cleats on the back, because you really want this to hang flush and be sturdy.
Yep.
If you were to use anything else, it was going to sort of tilt and lean. You don't want that. I've already got them up on here.
Right.
And then all we're going to do is slide
Look how good that looks already.
So easy and so simple. And French cleats are very, very forgiving.
I know what you're thinking. I know you're thinking that there's some ripples.
You don't see those wrinkles or ripples? I have this big thing. Not that that was planned. I'll get that big thing to put it on
camera. I'm the one who glued that one on, everybody. I did my best. Now,
but
as
if you have no wrinkles, then feel free to not put much in front.
Wow. Another dig. But I'd like to point out how great this looks, the way the can, you kind of like stack these together, and you really filled the space. And of course, depending on the size of the wall that you're filling, you can really adjust.
Like, if you had cathedral ceilings and you never know what to do with, you could do this all the way up 2 stories high. But if you had a little corner in a nursery or a little reading nook, a bunch of little shelves with beautiful little trinkets in it, this is really very inexpensive and can expand or contract to whatever amount of space you have.
Or your buddy Cam's den.
Exactly. Well, that's where these are going afterwards, right?